Hey everybody, this is Alessandro, welcome back. So today I want to study with you this very interesting and cool sequence from The Witcher, right? It's a combat sequence, there is also an introduction. There is really a lot to study in terms of choreography, camera, staging, timing. And, you know, in the previous tutorial we discussed about it, you know, camera, lenses and stuff like that. So I thought about it was really nice with you guys. Looking up a professional movie and this scene is done really, really well. And maybe give you, you know, some of my thoughts, why it makes this scene so cool. And, you know, maybe can inspire you, you know, especially if you guys want to do some combat sequence or things like that. Because staging, I think, like, it's really fundamental, guys. So if you're already familiar with this shot, you know, with this sequence, you can skip to the second part of the video. Or else we can just watch it for a few minutes together, okay? I will just play it right now.
She knew you'd come.
Where's Renfrey?
She's at the tower with your little friend, Marilka.
She gave us a message to pass on to you. You have to choose the lesser evil.
It's an ultimatum. Get it? Fuck.
Clarity that we have, especially during the combat. We'll talk a little bit more about that later. Let's start right from the beginning, right? So, as you can see, we have here Geralt, right? On the left side of the screen. See how very clear his stage, right? We have him on the left side of the screen. His blur, right? Really dark color on him. And on the right side here, we have, you know, the environment, the people here and everything. Lighter color, okay? This part here on the right side, on the right side of the screen, it's all crisp image, okay, compared to the blur on the left, brighter color. So immediately you see like how the scene is split in two parts, and it's like, yes, I can feel the sense of him, but at the same time this other part of the screen is very clear in terms of color, motion blur, depth of field and everything, right? And the more we go forward, let me actually remove the audio here. The more we go forward, you can see the attention switch to the center, and now he is on frame at the center, is on focus now, and everything else here is blur, right? So you see, like, again, this transition is very simple. There are basically two key points here, him from the left, blur, and then here to the center, right on focus, right? So it's very easy, I mean, easy in the sense of execution, but it's very well planned and very well staged, right? Again, we keep him on focus. Then we see him here walking against the crowd. Again, we start with the camera where the character is here is mostly three-quarter, right? Facing this direction. And we can see a bit of the background, the environment and everything. And the more we move forward, the camera slowly started to go more to the center, right? Again, simple transition. But it's super effective, right? Again, I always say this, like, a good staging, it doesn't require a lot of camera movement. You know, if you were animating this in 3D, regarding the camera, you could just do a two simple key, right? One here from the beginning, slightly three-quarter, and then here more in front of it, right? You wouldn't need any crazy number of key or stuff like that, right? So again, simplicity and clear staging is always the key here. Again, here we go back to the center, right? And again, look at this. We go back on what we had before where, you know, he's here, right, to the center, on focus. We don't really care what we see in the background because it's all blur, right? But while we move forward, look clearly, for example, this woman here, she's going to this side of the screen. And as soon as she moves away, she reveals this character, right? And suddenly you see how Geralt here starts to get blur, right? See how it started to shift more on the side? So we get more space to this character. And this character now start to be more on focus. So you see at the same time, they are shifting the focus from, and you have still this other character passing in front of him. You know, and now we have the fully focus on this character over here, right? Again, Geralt is on all blur here on the left side. You have a clear composition here, right? Boom, with everything really on focus here, clean horizontal line over here, and so on, right? Again, you see, we started from the center like this, again, slowly shifting on the side, and reveal all the enemy here, right? Again, it's done in a simple way, but very efficient. They play without the character shift on the side, camera as well, shifting a little bit on the right, and motion blur as well, right? Again, this is a very simple composition, but very effective, okay? Bring these two characters very close to each other, right? And you see how, you know, there is the contrast again between all the light here and the darkness here. And again, see how they use the line of action of the background kind of to pointing at this direction, right? I don't know if you guys study this, but, you know, line in the background can really help a lot where you want to focus, right? In this case, is Geralt, is this arrow over here. So again, those things are really, really help you to focus and to guide your eye direction. And I love actually to study those things because it's really, really interesting. And again, over here, very simple, darken the line of action here on Geralt, and then we have all the character here, framed very well. You can see the face, the stance, and everything is really well done. And again, we have an expression from him, nothing really. And again, see also this one. See how we start this with framing, where we have basically, we started the focus on here on this character, right? We barely can see this one. It's almost out of frame at the beginning, right? Very nice pose and everything, right? And then slightly transitioning until these two characters kind of overlap, right? And they create a very nice organic silhouette for both of them, right? See how they're kind of grouped very well together. And then they have all the background here, right? Again, it's really very well, nice stage. And again, with very simple movement. And then again, we have the camera transition here, quick pan, and again, we focus on this character. Again, you see how it's well staged, you know, being cut here right on the chest. A bit of blur on this character in the back, right? The secondary character here, right? The camera is tracked on him. And then we cut on action here. We cut on the movement. And until the guy is settling here into the center, into the previous shot, because we already have this shot before. And it helps, you know, when you cut like this on the action, when the character is walking in and he's about to stop, it really helps to make the cut smoother, right? You see also here kind of reinforcing because he's looking at him, right? Again, we have a reaction from Geralt. Same here, we go back to this one, a few reaction shots. And then I really love this sequence. This is really nice. What I like is the composition and the timing, okay? Because you see there is an easy in, easy out in terms of timing, right? You can see that basically, again, look how well framed it is. Look about this, study this one. Look how the crossbow is pointing already in this direction to Geralt, right? Look how really well is framed. Really good job on this. You see like how really well done this is. And then again, you see like how quickly we go to the other side and now we are slowing down, okay? You see there is an acceleration and a slowdown, okay? Because you really wanna focus on the dart, right? I guess this is the main shot of this moment, right? So after a quick pen, we are slowing down, boom, right? Again, reveal the face of the character, still maintaining the focus of the of this one on the cro- on the dart of the crossbow, right? See how really well it's framed. We have some negative space over here, right? And then again, look, as soon as the dart shots, boom, we go really fast. Again, another acceleration. We hold it here for quite a few frames only, right? It's just for a quick slowdown here on the dart, and then boom, we reveal Geralt, you know, we go focus on him, smashing the, you know, the dart and everything, boom, right? Now we have the focus on him, okay? We see him, Geralt, doing this badass move and everything, and now we stay for like a second, 2 seconds on him, kind of to read his face expression. I think this is something I really love about this sequence, that you do not only see the action clearly, but there is always focus on the facial expression, which make really the character more badass and can show the emotion. Then again, here, quick, fast movement, and look what I'm revealing it. Again, Geralt on the center, right? And we can clearly see the anticipation of this guy. See, both of them, they have their own space. This is really staged very well. And then here we cut, you know, there is a cut on action here on the slash, on the parry. Like, it's also nice to study line of action for me, for the body, the pose, and everything looks really cool. So they do a cut here on the parry, and from here we start a very long sequence of combat that looks really amazing. Again, look how the two characters are framed properly. You know, there is a proper nice gap between these two characters, right? Another thing that I love, after he killed the character, boom, there is a moment of pause. You see, it did not, nothing, I mean, combat doesn't always have to be frenetic, camera shaking, you know, things where you don't really see, can see clearly what's going on. What I really about these things, it takes his time to show off some of the brutality and some of the moment. You see here, for example, you can clearly see the sword going through his mouth, right? Holding this moment for a few seconds, and then boom. And then see the contrast between this one to this one. Boom. Look how even the contrast in the line of action, beside the camera staging and the choreography and the direction, I also love to study those contrasts here because they look so cool, right? Look at between these two, boom, right? There is a lot of contrast and dynamism that you can learn and you can take inspiration. And again, you still have time to read this anticipation before the actual action, right? Then again, here, see how he's walking really slowly? You know, this is actually more about acting. He show you how confident it is about what he's about to do, right? He show you that he's a badass, that he's, you know, what he's doing, he's not rushing on everything. He's taking his time to prepare for combat. And then we have this other sequence that is actually happening a bit faster, right? A sequence of combat and strikes that now it's time to have a more pace action, but again, still very, very clear, right? Again, see how he's coming in frame here with this anticipation, right? Anticipation on both sides, right? Before the strike. Look how they are always, both of them, very clear. This scene is really nice, really well played. Boom, and you see that now you have him in the center, kind of overlapping him, because obviously him doesn't matter anymore, he just died, you know, this is not important anymore. But again, see how it's always well framed, his face. You know, you don't always can see clearly in the sense that you always have a pause or anything, but you can feel it. You know, when everything is staged properly, even when things happen fast, you can still feel it, right? And again, you see here, sometimes things are working even if it happens off screen. This lash, this parry, basically happened off screen for this guy, but you can still feel it, right? And again, another anticipation here, right? You have this guy over here, now it's more clear what's going on. And then boom. His reaction. Again, both of them kind of overlapping, right? Here in the center. See? Very well framed. And same here. You see he's doing something here. You can't really tell what's going on because you don't see this character. But again, in the sense of combat, sometimes it's okay if it gets a bit messy. But again, it's still done properly. And now you reveal, you know, this character, the other character over here. So it's happening a bit of frame at the beginning, and then the camera catch up and reveal what's going on, right? Same things here. See how his movement is leading the camera, it's leading the action, right? See how his eyes kind of leading, looking already here, telling you there is something going on this side. And then boom. Look how well this stage is really phenomenal. Doing all this sequentially, guys. I can imagine how many times they must have tried this. And it's so beautiful for me to study, you know? Boom, very clear. And another things that I really like, see how he's in the center, we have this other guy over here, you know, preparing his attack, right? Look at like we have both of them left and right, and then in the middle, in the center, obviously you're not gonna focus on him, but again, he's there in the composition, ready to be exposed. See how they're changing side. See how they're changing side here. Right, they are both switching off from Geralt on the right and these guys on the left. And these guys now still in the center, because at some point I assume the focus is going to switch on him, right? So this is all planned and done really, really well. And you see, in fact, the guy is kind of here. And once he gets killed, he sees he's going down, bump. And look who's revealing him. That he was there all along, right? He was loading his dart, his crossbow and everything. And again, you see how it's clearly on the right, left side, sorry. Geralt is here preparing his next move, right? And see, now at the end, we frame it properly. We have it here on the left side, and Geralt doing the anticipation here. Boom. Really, really amazing. I kill him, and again you see like how we have enough time to see this guy going down. Geralt is anticipating the camera movement. It's going to the right, and then the camera catch up, right? It goes in front of him. We see the anticipation and we can feel, you know, what's coming next. And again, Geralt is on the side here. Boom, he's doing his magic. And on the other side, we are revealing, you know, this bunch of guy here, right? Camera goes behind him. Again, see, everything is still very clear. You can see his anticipation. See, like, you can really feel the face expression, the angerness, the desperation. You can see how the pair is clear. Again, see how we are going from this stage, Geralt on the left, and these guys on the right. On the other way around. And the way I like it is because, again, when we switch, same things. Look who are revealing it. Look how very nice this is framed. This is really great. You know, see, you have all the darkness here. Again, look how they play with light. They have all this dark silhouette with the Geralt and the enemy. And then in the light here, they're revealing this guy. Boom. Right. And then again, same here. Geralt stays on this side. This guy moves shifty on the left side. Right. This almost could be. It's so good. It seems like almost someone had to animate something like this. I'm wondering if they did a pre-visualization in 3D for something like this. Would be really cool. And, okay. It kills him. Again, they take some time here. They slow down after all that crazy action, and slow down a little bit more here to show off this moment, right? boom. And you see again, once you see that the focus is this on these two guys, right? Boom. And then when it's coming down, we are revealing this guy over here. Then we continue. We fully, this is like the big boss, more or less. It's not putting up a lot of a fight, but still, you know, again, we have bigger contrast from the big silhouette of Geralt and the small one over here, right? And boom, go to the fight, tack. Again, we are holding this moment. You see how it's very clear what is going on. You can see that it's kind of struggling in the face. You know, you can sense, okay, this guy is doomed. You know, you can feel in the posture the how confident Geralt is, right? You can feel the struggle from this guy, right? So you know this guy's gonna die. Boom. Shotting him. Pushing him here. And same here. Look at like this transition. We're going from the face of this guy, which is basically defeated. It's gonna be decapitated right now. We're going from his expression to reveal Geralt, you know? That he has this kind of confidence, badass pose and look to reveal how badass he is as a character, right? So yeah, guys, I think there is really a lot to study about this. I, in general, love to go through the sequence and study why it makes them so good. And there is always something you can learn. I feel like I love to spend this, you know, time in this. And I encourage you guys to do this as well, because I know we're an animator and a lot of animators don't really want to focus on camera staging and stuff like that. But I think for me, it's an extra skill that most animators should have. Especially if you guys work in games and cinematic, where sometimes you have a lot of motion capture, you just have to focus on camera. And yeah, so I think it's really beautiful to watch. And if you have any question or if you want me to study more of these things, guys, let me know. And hope you learned something, and see you next time, guys. Ciao.